How's it going, guys? So, the video you're about to watch is a bit choppy audio-wise, so bear with me. I just kept it that way because it was really filled with raw emotion and things that I actually felt at the time. So later on, I'll actually re-record it for you guys, but right now, I just wanted to get everything off my chest and actually record the series while it was fresh and dope in my head. So, have fun, guys. What up, guys? It's Yuro. And there never seems to be enough time. There's always... There's always something happening in the world. And when you think about it, there's always something that is missing. But the point is to make yourself happy with the things that you do have. Because you can't be in two different places at the exact same time if life worked out. And even if cloning was a thing, you wouldn't be experiencing these things, your clone would. So you still wouldn't be at the same time. Life don't work that way. But there's never enough time in this life to actually make things even morbid. But it's the time that you do make should be the most important things in your life. Like, come to me, not just recently, but it's been with me for a little bit of time, that I don't want to waste time. And these time capsule videos have made that a little bit more prevalent to me. Like, max we have on this earth is 100, and it's even more astonishing to live even further than that. But we have 100 years on this earth. And if I go back to my whole fraction, how I perceive life, you know, fractions, by the max, you lived 1/100th of your life. As a pie chart, that looks fucking stupid. Like, if that was a pizza, you'd get like nothing. If that was a piece of cake, you'd get, like, nothing. But that's what drives us as humans to create and be more than what we are, and hopefully leave behind a legacy of individuals that will also live 1/100th of their life, so that we can be remembered. Not just remembered, but, like, make life better for someone else. And through these, I feel like I'm teaching you guys, not just about myself, but giving you guys a perspective on things that perhaps you guys are actually to run into. Because my parents used to tell me, or my mom used to tell me, because I grew up to a single mom. But my mom used to tell me that... Sorry, I'm getting a little bit sidetracked. Sometimes, like, when I ramble on, I forget what the fuck I was talking about. Fuck was it? There's time. There's time. And that's how you know that us as humans, or maybe just me, I don't like talking and thinking about time so much as I like to be not just remembered by, but like to teach. That's what it was. So, my mom used to tell me that she's been through exact same things that I went through. I was like, Mom, you can be going through the exact same thing I've gone through. I mean, I'm a kid. You grew up in a different time era. I'm part of a whole different other fucking, you know, decade of children. But she did. And everyone that is older than you that tells you that, they have. Because the same things as far as bullying, wants, needs, contests, strategies as far as people, like, the game will always change. And by that, I mean strategies or the forms of things will always change. But the players, the people that enact those things, always stay the same. Parents' words. The game, the player, is the only thing that changes. They didn't say it in those. The player changes. The player change, but the game remains the same. Basically. Basically, that's the saying. And it's true. Over time, there's bullies. And those bullies then become either remorseful for their ways, criminals. Just how it is. Or you might be depressed at this time, but it then changes. So time isn't just this like robber. It's also something to like learn from. And with time, in time all wounds do heal. And that's not me quoting, this is like a long fucking quote from a long time ago. Like, it might be even from Shakespeare. I'm not, like, even up. But, like, back in Shakespearean times, this fucking quote was fucking, like, brought up. Like, if all the way back then, saying like this could actually... What makes you think a decade, a century... stops us from being. Time. We have so little of it, and yet it's wasted each and every day. So I implore you and encourage you guys, make the most of it. And how you make the most of it? Anything that you find fun, anything that's a joy for you, go out and do it. If it makes you money, do it even more. but life is nothing if you're just sitting there being depressed. Because that depression and stress is a whole different other story for another time. But the time you create and the memories that you create are essential, and it's what makes life. Nothing else matters, because if you are sitting there being depressed, that's your life. Depressing. If you live your life stressed, that's your life. Stressful. And anyone that like says that they don't want a happy life, I don't know. Maybe there are people who don't have a happy life. I'm not one of them, though. Because I try to live as happy as possible. And thereby, I try to fill my time with fun and happiness. Thereby leading a... This is actually one way that I fucking do it. Entertaining you guys. Giving you guys a outlet to talk to somebody that actually has lived 1/25th of their life and has the exact experiences that you had, and how I've dealt with it could be solutions for you. So take these time capsules kind of to heart. Not saying take all of them to heart, shit that I'm fucking cringy and ridiculous. But take them to heart, because like, you could run into those same exact situations. Look back on this and know and be prepared to actually handle those things, because that's one less thing that you stress about. So without further ado, thank you guys so much for watching. I'm Yuro. I'll see you in the next video. Let's go. I've been watching.